Hello everybody, myself Mr. Birajdar Bala Sahib, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video lecture, we will discuss Laplace transforms of integrals. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to find Laplace transform of integrals of function f of t. Let us start with statement of Laplace transform of integrals. It states that if Laplace transform of f of t equal to f of s, then Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt is equal to 1 upon s into f of s. Now proof of this statement. Let us suppose phi of t equal to given integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt. When we put t equal to 0 in this result, we get phi of 0 equal to 0. And when we differentiate this result with respect to t on both the side, we get phi dash of t equal to, now derivative of right hand side integration with respect to t gets cancelled, we get f of t. So that phi dash of t equal to f of t. Now by property Laplace transform of derivatives, we can write Laplace of phi dash of t equal to s into Laplace of phi of t minus phi of 0, which is equal to, now phi of 0 is equal to 0, we know that, so that s into Laplace of phi of t. From this result we can write Laplace of phi of t equal to 1 upon s into Laplace of phi dash of t, which is equal to 1 by s as it is, Laplace of phi dash of t, we can write Laplace of f of t, because phi dash of t equal to f of t. Therefore, when we replace phi of t equal to integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt, which is assumed in the left hand side, and Laplace of f of t equal to f of s in the right hand side. So we get Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt equal to 1 upon s into f of s. This is the required property, hence the proof. Now working rule to solve the problems. To find Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt, we have to follow these steps. Step 1. First of all, note down the value of integrand function f of t. Step 2. Find the Laplace transform of this function f of t and denote it by f of s, that is Laplace of f of t equal to f of s. Now step 3. Write Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt equal to 1 upon s into f of s. Means replace f of t by given function in the left hand side and its Laplace transform f of s in the right hand side, which gives required answer. Now let us consider the example. Example 1. Find the Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t of e raised to minus 2t into t cube into dt. Here integrand function e raised to minus 2t into t cube is denoted by f of t, and now we have to find its Laplace transform. First of all, we find Laplace transform of t cube, which is equal to gamma of 3 plus 1 upon s raised to 3 plus 1. Due to the formula, Laplace of t raised to n equal to gamma of n plus 1 upon s raised to n plus 1. Now we have to simplify right hand side, which is equal to gamma 4 upon s raised to 4, which is equal to gamma 4 is 3 factorial using gamma property upon s raised to 4, which is equal to 3 factorial means 6 upon s raised to 4. Now by first shifting theorem we discussed earlier, that is Laplace transform of e raised to minus a t into f of t equal to f of s plus a, when Laplace of f of t equal to f of s. By this property we can write Laplace transform of e raised to minus 2 t into t cube is equal to, in the Laplace transform of t cube, that is 6 upon s raised to 4, we have to replace every s equal to s plus 2, that is equal to 6 upon s plus 2 bracket raised to 4, and this result is denoted by f of s. Now by property Laplace transform of integrals, that is Laplace of integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt equal to 1 upon s into f of s. So by this property we can write Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t of e raised to minus 2t into t cube into dt equal to 1 upon s as it is into f of s means 6 upon s plus 2 bracket test 4, which is equal to 6 divided by s in bracket s plus 2 bracket test 4 is the required answer. Now pause the video for a while, write the answer to the question. Question is, find Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t hyperbolic cos of 2t dt. Come back. I hope you have written answer to this question. Here I will going to explain the solution. Question is, find the Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t of hyperbolic cos 2t into dt. Here f of t means hyperbolic cos of 2t. Now we have to find Laplace transform of hyperbolic cos of 2t, which is equal to s upon s square minus 2 square, which is equal to s upon s square minus 4, denoted by f of s. So this is by using formula Laplace of hyperbolic cos a t equal to s upon s square minus a square. Now by property Laplace transform of integrals, we can write Laplace of integration of f of t dt with limit 0 to t equal to 1 upon s into f of s. By this property we can write Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t of hyperbolic cos 2t dt equal to 1 upon s as it is, and f of s is here s upon s square minus 4. Now s gets cancelled, we get answer to this question is 1 upon s square minus 4. Now example 2, find the Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t t sin 3t dt. Here f of t equal to t sin 3t. Now we have to find Laplace transform of this using effect of multiplication by t property. For that, first we find Laplace transform of sin of 3t, which is equal to 3 upon s square plus 3 square, which is equal to 3 upon s square plus 9, because of the formula Laplace of sin at equal to a upon s square plus a square. Now by effect of multiplication by t property, we know that Laplace of t into f of t is equal to minus 1 into d by ds of f of s. So by this property we can write Laplace transform of t into sin 3t equal to minus 1 into d by ds of f of s means 3 upon s square plus 9. Now we have to differentiate this 3 upon s square plus 9 with respect to ts using quotient rule. We get minus 1 as it is, now keeping s square plus 9 in numerator as it is, and derivative of numerator 3 is 0, minus numerator 3 as it is, and derivative of denominator is 2s, divided by s square plus 9 bracket square, which is equal to minus 1 as it is into, now in numerator, minus 6 into s, divided by s square plus 9 bracket square. Therefore, Laplace transform of t into sin 3t is equal to 6s upon s square plus 9 bracket square. Denote this result by f of s. Now, by property Laplace transform of integrals, that is Laplace of integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt equal to 1 upon s into f of s. By this property we can write Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t of t into sin 3t dt equal to 1 by s as it is. Now f of s means 6s upon s square plus 9 bracket square. Now s gets cancelled, which is equal to 6 upon s square plus 9 bracket square. This is the required answer. Now another example, example 3, find the Laplace transform of integration with limit 0 to t of e raised to minus t sin 2t upon t dt. Here f of t is e raised to minus t into sin 2t upon t. Now we have to find its Laplace transform using suitable properties. First of all, we find Laplace transform of sin 2t, which is equal to 2 upon s square plus 4, because Laplace transform of sin a t equal to a upon s square plus a square. Now by effect of division by t property, Laplace transform of f of t upon t is equal to integration with limit s to infinity of f of s ds. So using this property, we can write Laplace transform of sine 2t upon t is equal to integration with limit s to infinity of 2 upon s square plus 4 into ds. Now take 2 is outside, and in bracket, integration of 1 upon s square plus 4 with respect to s is 1 upon 2 into tan inverse of s by 2, bracket close, with limit s to infinity. Now 2 gets cancelled, and when we put s equal to upper limit infinity, we get tan inverse of infinity minus, when s equal to lower limit s, we get tan inverse of s by 2. Therefore, Laplace transform of sin 2t upon t is equal to, now tan inverse of infinity means pi by 2, minus tan inverse of s by 2, which is equal to, now pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s by 2, we can write as cot inverse of s by 2. Now by force shifting theorem, that is Laplace transform of e raised to minus a t into f of t, we can write as f of s plus a. Therefore, by this property, we can write Laplace transform of e raised to minus t into sin 2t upon t is equal to, in the Laplace transform of sin 2t upon t, that is cot inverse of s by 2, we have to replace every s equal to s plus 1, which is equal to cot inverse of s plus 1 by 2. Now by property, Laplace transform of integrals, we know that Laplace of integration with limit 0 to t f of t dt equal to 1 upon s into f of s. By using this property, we can write Laplace transform of given integration with limit 0 to t e to power minus t sin 2t upon t dt is equal to 1 upon s as it is, and here f of s means cot inverse of s plus 1 upon 2. This is the required answer for the given example. To prepare this video lecture, I use these two books as references. Thank you.